The changes seemed almost like they were taking away the old, you know, taking away our history.
It will be years before families line the beaches of the Cape Coral Yacht Club or swim in the pool or celebrate weddings at the Rotino Center or walk the pier. Today, the city confirmed that Cape Coral's gemstone destination will be demolished and must be rebuilt from the ground up. Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. The over 60-year-old yacht club was no match for Hurricane Ian's storm surge and 150-mile-per-hour winds. It just wrecked everything. NBC2's Tori Kinley is at the yacht club tonight with what we can expect to happen in the coming months.
Behind me, you can see crews working on the Cape Coral Yacht Club. The buildings won't be standing for long. The city plans to start tearing them down in September.
The ballroom itself was a focal point in the whole community from day one.
Richard Metzger is like many people in the Cape who miss visiting the beach, pool, and restaurant at the yacht club. It's been a destination since the 60s, a place to relax and put your feet in the water.
You know, it was one of the most historical. This is the most historical area in the Cape.
But Hurricane Ian destroyed it. The city has spent the past 7 months working with insurance companies on rebuilding. The new timeline is to tear down the buildings, including the Rotino Center, in September if FEMA okays it. Residents say they understand why the yacht club has to come down, but ask the city to keep parts of the charm.
We ask them to keep would be the fountain out front, the multicolored fountain, and the fireplace inside the main building.
The Boathouse restaurant is set to open later this month. The city also wants to send down divers around the destroyed pier to look for debris. Rebuilding the yacht club is expected to take years. I'm reporting local in Cape Coral, Tori Kinley, NBC2.